Nemi-Vlog comes at the request of a Patreon supporter, Kavi. Kavi wanted to know if I had a least favorite movie genre, and to be honest with you guys, I had a hard time with this idea because I really do make an effort to just never close myself off from anything as far as types of movies go, so I thought I'd approach this in a slightly different way. I'm going to share three movies that made me more excited about their respective genre than I might have been before, genre or subgenre rather. So let's kick this list off with something that's rather familiar, and that's vampires. Clearly, the Twilight films were huge hits, and I give the folks that were part of them all the credit in the world for striking a chord with so many moviegoers out there, because clearly this franchise was very important to them, but the movies really weren't for me, and they kind of dulled my interest in vampires on the big screen. But then we got a little gem called What We Do in the Shadows from Jermaine Clement and Taika Waititi. If you haven't seen it, it's a mockumentary about four roommates who also happen to be vampires. And what makes it so special isn't the fact that it steers away from familiar vampire tropes and cliches, but rather that it embraces them, but in a very clever and delightful way. You fall in love with these guys as a group. You can't help but to have some fun picking your favorite vampire. The world building in this movie is just incredible. Every element of everyday life for these guys is kind of a joy to discover and experience. I really just can't get enough of this movie. And it just goes to show that a topic can feel stale and overused, but it is possible to breathe new life into it with a clear vision. And in this case, that vision is just loaded with humor and charm. Next up, I am giving The Shape of Water a whole lot of credit for filling the monster movie loving void in my heart that The Mummy left. I really wanted The Mummy and the Dark Universe to work, but unfortunately, it seems like the studio cared a little more about making the Dark Universe a thing rather than starting it off with a really strong standalone first feature. But regardless of my disappointment in The Mummy, I still wanted to see what else Universal had to offer with the classic monsters, especially because I was looking forward to what they were aiming to make next, Bill Condon's Bride of Frankenstein. Sure, there are reports that Condon is still attached to that project, and the studio itself never really said that the Dark Universe is dead, but considering the two guys leading the charge, Alex Kurtzman and Chris Morgan, left at the beginning of November, just doesn't really seem like the whole revamped monster movie franchise idea is heading in a very promising direction now. But if you are like me and you're looking for an exceptional monster movie right now, Guillermo del Toro has you covered. His latest, The Shape of Water, is one of my favorite movies of 2017. Features Doug Jones as the creature, who delivers a wildly expressive performance paired with incredible makeup work. The story is really a beautiful exploration of being an outcast and embracing uniqueness. For my last item in this video, I'm going to address the question a little more directly, probably as Kavi intended. I can be a tough sell when it comes to studio comedies, and this year wasn't really the best for that kind of stuff. Got Rough Night, Baywatch, Snatched, and then some. They all kind of range from fine to not so good at all, with Girls' Night being the exception, but what I'm going for here is that I seem to have responded much more strongly to 2017 comedies that were, let's say, less traditional or maybe even genre mashups. For example, I had a ton of fun with The Antics and Logan Lucky. Smart, well-paced, the comedy is on point throughout. But I think the movie that actually made me laugh the most this year was Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri, which shocked me. It is a dark comedy, and it addresses some very serious situations and topics, yet this still probably had me laughing out loud more than any film I saw this year, and the fact that that combination can work so well really just astounded me. And I also have to give a shout out to The Disaster Artist. I just rewatched it the other night, and I must have been grinning from ear to ear almost the entire time. And I say almost because I think James Franco and the screenwriters did a fantastic job letting you laugh at their antics in the movie, but while never losing sight of the fact that these are real people who gave something that they were really passionate about their all. So, Kavi, there you go. Some thoughts on genres and subgenres that haven't really been working for me recently, but then movies that help turn things around. If you guys have had similar experiences, please share them in the comments section below. And if you want to make a video suggestion like Kavi did, that's what the Patreon campaign is for. You'll find a link to that below. So thank you again for watching this video. See you guys real soon.